The unopinionated nature of React is a two-edged sword. On the one hand, you get freedom of choice. On the other hand, many projects end up with a custom and often messy architecture. This video is the third part of a series about software architecture and React apps, where we take a code base with lots of bad practices and refactor it step by step. Previously, we created the initial API layer and extracted fetch functions that can be used in the components. This way, we already removed a lot of implementation details related to API requests from the UI code. But we're not done yet. In this video, we identify data transformations in the component that can be moved to the API layer. Let's have a look at a problematic code example. Here's a user profile component that fetches data from two different endpoints. So what's the problem? We have the raw response data structures inside the component. But if you think about it, the UI code shouldn't care that the user object is returned as response.data, and it shouldn't need to know that the shouts are in response.data and the images inside response.included. Imagine we pass these response data structures to a dozen or more components in a larger project. Now imagine that the API changes the data structure. We'd have to adjust all of those components one by one. Additionally, the code would be more readable if we wouldn't have to deal with all those data and included fields anymore. Name it user, shout, or image instead. To summarize, all this knowledge can be hidden inside the API layer, as this is where we deal with API responses, and the fetch functions should return the final user, shout, or image data structures. So what's the solution? The goal is to remove all code related to API response data structures from the component. The solution is to use data transformations in the fetch functions. As you can see, the fetch functions directly return the response data. Instead, we can retrieve the desired data, like the user, from the response and return that. In the getUserShouts function, we do the same. This time, the shouts are in the data field and the images in the included field. By the way, you think the response data structure with the data and included fields looks weird? You might not have encountered the popular JSON API standard. Now the fetch functions return the actual data structures like user, shout, or image. This allows us to remove the response data structures from the component. As you can see, all the code related to responses has vanished from the component. Not to forget that we got rid of the nasty data and included fields. At the same time, the only changes so far are that we returned some nested fields instead of the complete response, and that we renamed some fields. Clearly, things can be more complex, so let's have a look at another example. Here's another component of the example project. It's a feed that shows the news shouts, aka tweets, to a user. We can again see that the response is stored in the component. But what's the problem apart from that? These two lines are the difference. Apparently, we again have to deal with an included field, but this time the array not only contains images but also users. And these two lines are data transformation logic that separates these types. That means we have data transformation logic inside the component. But the component shouldn't care that the included field in the feed response contains users and images, and it shouldn't need to know that it can distinguish the users and images by the type field. So what's the solution? Again, the goal is to remove this logic from the component. The solution is simple. We move the two lines of data transformation logic to the fetch function. Now the fetch function returns the actual data structures, user, shout, and image, and doesn't expose API responses to the UI code anymore. The component becomes a lot simpler. Now the component directly gets the users, shouts, and images. It has no knowledge of the API responses anymore. Great, our code becomes more streamlined, but so far we only focus on response data. What about input data like request bodies? Here's yet another example component. A dialogue that allows the user to reply to another user's shout. The chained requests are a problem for the future. Here we focus on the preparation of the input data, particularly the image upload. So what is the problem? It appears that the media API expects the image to be added to a form data object. But is this something the component should be concerned with? Why should it matter to the UI whether the image is uploaded using form data or any other mechanism? Let's imagine we wanted to switch to another cloud storage like AWS S3. We'd most likely have to adjust the component code as well. And since other places, like the user profile, are likely to upload images as well, we'd have to adjust multiple parts of the code base just because the underlying image storage changed. We can do better. So what's the solution? You guessed it. Similar to the previous examples, let's move the data transformation to the API layer. The fetch function in the API layer now expects a file as input. The exact upload mechanism is hidden from the component. This simplifies the component code quite a bit. The component is still responsible for getting the files from the event target and passing only the first file to the media API. The rest of the heavy lifting is handled by the API. What are the next refactoring steps? We took another step closer towards a cleaner React architecture. Data transformations are now handled by the API layer. But there's still room for improvement. For example, the fetch functions still pass the data structures user, shout, or image as they are returned from the API. And look at this example. It ain't pretty, right? In the next article, we will introduce a domain layer that will help us get rid of this complexity.